prophets are God's watchmen, not just over people in church, but over nations. I've said the over nations, to root out, to plant, to destroy. Now, he said, I've this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms, to root out, to pull down, and to destroy, and to throw down, and to build, and to plant. Prophets are builders. They root out what will not the buildings take place, so they can plant God's purpose on the earth. I want to speak to the conscience of this nation and her leaders as a prophet this morning. And please listen to me. I've set thee a watchman. You shall hear a word from me and give them warning. Now it says in verse 18, when I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou giveth him not warning, nor speaketh to him to warn the wicked from his wicked way to save his life, the same wicked shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will be required from you. That is the awesome responsibility of prophets. Now listen to these lines. A wake-up call to a nation in a state of slumber. Insurgency is spreading across the nation under the guise of Fulani House men. Danger is looming. For example, how many of these killers have been brought to book since their campaign of carnage, death, and destruction began? One may ask. They must have the backing of some invisible powers. A nationwide unrest is in the offing. That may be worse than the ISIS devastation going on in some parts of the world today. It is not enough, therefore, to pray, we must cry out. The destiny of this nation has never been under a threat of survival as it is today. People may soon be forced to take laws into their hands. The security apparatus of the nation has obviously failed to defend the lives and properties of these poor farmers across the nation. While we are claiming to curtail Boko Haram onslaught, we are on the other hand, sponsoring, in quote, or abetting the Fulani herdsmen and their murderous acts. Nigeria is a nation at war with ourselves. No external aggression, no ethnic crisis, no natural disaster, yet we are doing mass burials. What a nation in a state of slumber. Hear the voice of the Lord through this prophet. The soul of Nigeria is endangered. We are becoming an endangered species on the earth. God have mercy. God have mercy. I am saying this for you to know why you must pray and why and what is behind it. Now, listen to me. I'm going to share this with you. There are some 5 questions you have asked. Pertinent questions that border on the conscience of a nation and her leaders. Is cattle business government business? Should farmers be killed for Fulani herdsmen to live? Should all farmers leave their farms today for the threat of Fulani herdsmen? Would the nation survive? When we are still producing, as I'd like to know, 20% of what we eat. Should the farmers vacate their farms? Now the big question, what is the contribution of cattle business to Nigerian GDP? What is the contribution? Because I don't understand why. And every political bigot is silent. I'll never need an elected position in my life. I've been elected by God. Now, listen to me. There is more to this low response from government agencies in addressing this sensitive issue, which is obviously a time bomb. Does Nigeria land now belong to Fulani housemen? Are they now the customary land owners of every state, cities, towns, villages, and hamlets? Where then is the place of the owners of this land? There is danger in the offing. Every community may soon set up their own security system to defend the insurgency of the Fulani housemen. Can the citizens still trust the security agencies of this nation? When citizens can no longer trust government for security, a state of anarchy is in view. Insurrection may as well be on the way. This largely unchecked aggression of the Fulani herdsmen, so-called, may eventually choke the soul of Nigeria to death, God forbid. That's why you need to pray for God to visit the camps of these wicked men with his instruments of death and free the soul of Nigeria from the grave. Is our sense for human life still alive in Nigeria? Today, human beings are being slain for cattle without any drastic intervention from our security agents. Should men, women, and children continue to lay down their lives for cattle? There is no other nation where human life is placed at a lower ebb than animals. How are these killers making away with their murderous acts? They must have the backing of some powers that be. Any right thinking Nigerian will speculate same. Is Boko Haram not spreading strategically across the nation? I wish not. How many cows will the Fulani herdsman sell to buy an AK 47 rifle, which today stands at a cost of about 3 million naira? The biggest cattle in town is 180,000. They didn't buy them. Some sources supply them. Do you hire a mega in your one room apartment? Do you protect your asset of 1 million with 3 million security guns? No. Let's come down and pray. I pray that this nation will come awake from slumber and stop evil from coming. When Noah was speaking, they were laughing him to scorn. But suddenly, the flood of Noah came. Evil will not come on our nation. Evil will not come on this nation. I keep the rest. But understand, Nigeria needs rescue. We'll engage spiritual forces for our rescue, and we'll speak out words to warn. You cannot sell off the souls of men for your self ambition. Killing for any reason has no justification. Nigeria must be set free. Stand to your feet. What I've done this morning is to unmask the masquerade, so that the fear of what or who may be behind the mask may be non-existent. As we all know, until the masquerade is unmasked, we shall continue to fear what may be behind the mask. It's a wake-up call to take appropriate steps by all responsible to stem this evil tide. God bless me.